Meet Rafael Coelho. He's the executive director at Tidewise, a Brazilian technology-based company that provides autonomous and remotely operated unmanned surface vehicles for maritime operation that reduce environmental impact, operational costs, and risk to human life. The three words Rafael used were safe, autonomous, and service, explaining that Tidewise technology performs unmanned remote inspections in dangerous situations where having a human do it is just too risky. As you can imagine, the Tidewise team spend a lot of time at sea, getting up close and personal with real problems. So this is where inspiration strikes. And when they're not at sea, they are observing solutions and their key principles, then getting new ideas by using the lessons they've learned. Over at Tidewise, the team are driven by the simple yet very important need to develop and apply technology that can reduce the risks to human lives and have a positive impact on the environment. Now we know a bit about Rodrigo and Tidewise. Let's hear their innovative idea.
Hello everyone, my name is Rafael Coelho. I'm the co-founder of Tidewise, a company that's changing the way we work at sea by using unmanned marine vessels and other robots to collect data offshore. We all know that working offshore is costly, dangerous, and required throughout the project lifetime. We need to collect data since the very early days of the project when we are doing the FEED studies to understand the seabed conditions where we intend to install the infrastructure. During the installation phase, we need to collect data to guarantee the progress of the installation. And on the post-installation monitoring, we need to make sure the assets are working the way they should. And also we need to do routine inspection to guarantee things are safe. The Tidewise solution offers more data, better data, less risk to humans, and less environmental impact. And the way we are offering that is by using a combination of a drone and a USV that's going to work autonomously together, collecting data offshore. So if we compare the current solution and Tidewise solution, we require less people. We require less training to go offshore because people are going to mostly be working onshore remotely. The operational cost is going to be reduced. The weather window is lighter. That means the robots can work in a weather where humans are obliged to be onshore. And also the time response is shorter. That means it's quicker to mobilize our system than to mobilize a crewed vessel. This video is an example of the technology we developed last year. The technology was developed to detect oil in the sea surface, and we are now adapting it to collect offshore wind infrastructure data. The drone and the USV, they work together. The drone is able to land autonomously on the USV by detecting the position and the attitude of the USV landing platform. The drone can also be tethered. That means it receives power through a tether cable, and that increases the resilience and the robustness of the system. And also the drone will be able to fly for longer periods. On our solution, the drone is capable of collecting aerial image that can be normal cameras footage and also thermal cameras. The thermal cameras allows aliens to identify hotspots on the jackup platforms that could potentially be the beginning of a failure. The bottom image on your right is a mix combined data of LiDAR, so above surface cloud points, and also multi-beam echo sound data that's generated by a multi-beam echo sounder subsea. So this kind of data provides a very good understanding of the infrastructure installed, the seabed conditions, and the condition of the assets that are actually working. When we compare the values of the current solution and the solution we are offering, we have around 50% cost saving, and that comes from the cost of the vessels, the cost of people offshore. So we are taking people that would be working offshore and they are now working onshore, and also the data processing. Because we are acquiring data using robots, this data has a much higher accuracy than data obtained by humans. And that means we need less time to process this data. The system can also be used to do assessment of emergencies. Robots can be operated in very dangerous environments where humans should not be. The robots can be around the site, so they can be in standby mode, and they can be used as a remote sensor to provide data to onshore to people responsible to mitigate the emergency. We take regulations very seriously. Our operations procedures follow DNV guidelines and the IMO, the international regulations for operating unmanned marine systems. Our USV was designed and built according to DNV, and our drone system has a drone crash avoidance, and that means the USV is gyro stabilized, what will reduce the risks of landing and takeoff of the drone from the USV. And the tether is also an additional means of safety. The USV is 5 meters long and it fits on a 20-foot container. It was designed to operate in very harsh conditions. Up to 6.85, we can collect data safely, and this vessel can survive 6.10. That means it can stay offshore even when the weather is really harsh. So for the proof of concept, our plan is to operate the system from Rio and transmit the data to Belgium. So the system is going to be operated from Rio coastline, and we're going to do a survey on an island that just offshore of the coast. The drone is going to provide aerial image of the island, and the USV is going to provide subsea data and environmental data like wind and currents to the Helio group.
In future, the system can be used to inspect and monitor Helio's OZ platform and transmit data back 40 kilometers to shore. It also be possible to share the costs of the system operation with other stakeholders in the area, for example, the wind turbine operators. We foresee the implementation of this technology in three phases. First, in Q3 this year, we'll have the proof of concept here in Rio with a person from Helio's attending the operations. We would live stream all the data back to Belgium. Early next year, we'd have a pilot project on OZ's platform in Belgium. And later on, in Q3 next year, we'll design and build a fully electric solution to be charged using the electricity produced on site.
So I'm a naval architect. The other co-founder of Tidewise is Sylvain Jouet. He has a software background, a PhD in software development. And although we are Brazilians and based in Rio, we have very strong links with Europe. We have done projects with Q11 University in Belgium, the Ocean Cleanup in Netherlands, and IVA in Denmark. So thank you for your time.